All right, you guys, we're in Gig Harbor, Washington right now. We're with Griffin and his girlfriend, Kenzie, may come a little bit later. I've been following these guys for probably 6 months or so, maybe a little longer on Instagram, because they've been working on this boat. Lila is her name?
Yeah, yep.
And they've been just completely redoing her, and it looks, at least from the Instagram pictures, just looks absolutely beautiful. And they've been doing it for an Airbnb. So you guys just started renting it out, right?
Yeah, just about a week ago now.
Okay. So we're going to do a full-on boat tour. We're going to show you guys the whole boat, and then we're going to do a little podcast interview with Griffin and maybe Kenzie.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So if you guys want to check out the podcast, we'll just link it below. Here's the boat tour, and yeah, let's check it out.
Yeah, you know, Ken's did all the design, and you know, she did a great job picking stuff out, and you know, it was a team effort, but when it came to it, she was the one who had the vision. And when we first got it, you know, we walked in and like, oh, this will be easy, we're just gonna throw some beadboard up and maybe some new countertops, but it took way longer than we thought it would.
Yeah, always does.
When we bought it, you kind of walked in here, there was carpet everywhere throughout the boat, like literally every floor was carpet, even in the bathrooms. It had a wall that wrapped around here and closed off the galley.
Okay.
And so we opened that up. It had green wallpaper everywhere from floor to ceiling. So we took all that off, and new countertops, a new range that has an oven on it, and a microwave hood vent right here. New flooring throughout the boat. That was another mistake we made. We put the flooring in too early and it got scuffed up.
Oh, no.
Is this a vinyl click-in floor?
It is, yeah. It's a Pergo product, just from Home Depot. And it does pretty well. If I were to do it again, I would have gone with like the Lifeproof brand, I think it is.
Okay, that's
it
has, what we use in the camper.
Yeah, it has no wood product in it at all.
Is this waterproof?
It is, yeah. They call it spill resistant for 24 hours. And, you know, it hasn't, you know, we've had a skylight up there that leaked and we didn't get to it for a couple of days, but the floor was fine. The family we bought it from, too, they were the ones that actually commissioned the build in 1967. And so they had all the original blueprints for it. And so we laid them out on the, this is the original table that came with it, too, that John Fluke Jr. actually made. And so we laid the plans on it and did an epoxy tabletop for it.
That's amazing. Is this, it's a straight up pour over the plans?
It is. It's multiple layers, and then it has a UV resistant layer on the top because the epoxy will yellow. And
is that like a poly over it?
You know, Ken's was the one that did this. She'd know the actual product. She actually did the whole table here. She's, wow. You know, she did, you'll see up there too, we have some epoxy countertops up there.
That is really, really cool.
This is, I want to say it's called like a sisalgrass wallpaper, and it comes in like a grass color, like a beige, kind of like the rope there.
Yeah.
And we put it up and we didn't like the seams, and it got some stain marks on it from when we stained the trim, and so we just painted it all white.
Okay, I like it.
This is another one of our favorite things. The original owners of the boat, when they had it christened, had friends from around the world send them bottles of water from, you know, wherever they lived. And they filled their, instead of champagne, they filled a big bottle with water from around the world to christen the boat.
No way!
Yeah, there's a letter from Amsterdam and California. And
that's so cool.
And we have a day head in here.
Ooh, love the wallpaper.
Yeah. Oh, man. I'm sure everyone else isn't as excited, but these toilets are the best marine toilets you can get, and I'm sure camper toilets as well, the Dometic brand. Knowing that it was going to be a rental, you know, marine heads can just be problematic.
A nightmare.
Yeah.
What makes you say that they're better? We just haven't tried them yet.
The Master Flush specifically. Their macerators are just awesome.
So this is a heater vent?
Yeah, it's just a cadet heater from Home Depot. And
is that electric?
Yeah. Okay. Yep. And so, you know, it's, like I said, it's not set up to be a cruising boat yet because it's all shore power, AC. And these are only 500-watt units, so they don't pull a lot. But I did end up, we basically have 100-amp service here because I have two 50-amp shore cables now.
Oh, nice.
And then our appliances, like this range is 240, and then we have a residential Rheem 40-gallon water heater under the floor here. That's also 240, so I was able to create a separate 240 panel. So you can try your hardest, but I don't think you're going to pop a breaker on this boat.
I'll knock on wood.
Yeah. This is the pilot house up here. Sonar pedestal right here. It was like one of the ones you'd put your face in, and it looked like something off of a submarine. And so we just ripped all of it out and put a Venotemp right in where the chart table went. Other than that, I mean, nothing really changed layout wise up here. There's one a chip right here. You'll see in the master stateroom, there's some chipping going on.
So you sprayed it off.
Yeah, and this paint, this product is just absolutely amazing. I'm by no means a painter, and it doesn't want to run on you. It goes on, it almost gels up, and it was awesome. These lights were an awesome find too. They're just Home Depot LED lights, and each light in the boat before had its own switch on it, so you had to go around and manually switch on every light, and we didn't have enough room to run wires to normal switches, so we found little Bluetooth receivers on Amazon, and like all four of these lights are in the same circuit. So there's a little Bluetooth receiver in this light right here that goes to this switch right here, which is, I think they call it, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I think it's called like a kinetic switch or something. It runs off of its own electricity just by the pushing motion, so you don't have to plug it into anything. Saved us a lot of time with electrical.
So that, there's no wiring on that switch at all?
Not at all. Jeez. There's just a little screw in the back that screws it onto the wall.
That's amazing.
Did you take before and after photos?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Yep. She hasn't kept up with your Instagram.
Well, and the Instagram isn't even all of them. I mean, we have hundreds of pictures that we've taken along the way. And then down here. And there's green wallpaper anywhere, everywhere in the boat. And these are just like Home Depot veneer plywood pieces, and we stained them up, and there's a spray on varnish kind of, it's called All Grip.
Uh-huh.
And it was great. As you can see, I'm not the best sprayer because there's some orange peel in it, but it shined up pretty nice.
What was the veneer? What kind of wood?
I think they call it like a Moranti or something. It's a really thin plywood with one veneer sheet on it.
Uh-huh.
And it's, you know, we wanted to go for like a teak look, but uh-huh. It was not even close. But the stain we used was, it, you know, got us pretty close to what we wanted it to look like.
Yeah, it looks beautiful.
And the things are, oh, here's Ken's right here.
Hello!
Hi!
Sorry we've invaded your space.
No, it's okay.
It's nice to meet you guys.
You too.
I'm Kenzie.
Billy.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Kenzie.
Guys,
this panel came off.
Wow.
Yeah.
Last
panel came off.
Yeah. So the engine.
This is the engine room in here. It's a mess because I just haven't cleaned up at all. And unfortunately, there's no light in here.
Are they cats?
Yeah, they're caterpillar, old cats. They're D333Bs. So they're like old tractor engines and We did have some issues with especially the port side engine. It's still giving us a little bit of issues. Originally, it was overheating, so we replaced the heat exchanger, or we had it chemically treated to get all the rust out of it. And then it was great. And we were taking it back from Seattle after it got bottom painted, and now we have a turbo issue. It's like, it's probably not lubricating because it's getting really hot. And, but the engines are running. We've never had a problem with starting them, and they're pretty bulletproof, these Cat engines.
So. Yeah.
But that's probably next on my list. Due to the fact that it's sitting on the dock, I'm not too worried about it.
It's probably all mechanically injected and everything.
Exactly, yeah.
Jeez, that's amazing. Yeah,
you can kind of see our water heater back there. That's just a residential Home Depot Rheem 40-gallon water heater. It's a new battery charger we put into the left there. It has some marine stuff. We have a galvanic isolator up there, which prevents against shock if you're swimming around the dock. Other than that, it's kind of just a floating condo at this point. And we don't have light in there yet either, so it's pretty dark.
I love that door.
Yeah, it's pretty fun. And down here was where we did a lot of structural work and kind of reconfigured the room a little bit. This was just a solid skylight right here, so we put some plexiglass on it to bring some more light in. It was just a board on top.
Oh, wow.
There's a head up here that has a shower in it.
Same Dometic toilets, heads.
And the shower's around the corner there. One of the things I do like about this head is it has an actual shower in it. It's not just like a curtain with a...
Oh, yeah. Like a wet head.
Exactly, okay. Yeah.
That's awesome.
And then Kenz will explain about the shower in here, a certain paint that she used.
Okay.
Or like a giant hotel and every, like, bar. You know what
I mean? Our floors are a little different, too. We didn't want to put actual tile in, so Kenz just stenciled them and painted a little honeycomb tile on there.
So that's just all stencil and paint, and then what, a layer over it?
Just a clear coat on top of it, and it's like tile and bath paint, I think, and it goes on fiberglass. You know, we learned as we went, we did the back head first, and as you can see in the corners, it kind of gets a little wonky, but we learned to use a bigger stencil if we ever use it. Do it again. And this is the bunk room in here. This room is probably where a lot of my nightmares come from. We had a pretty severe leak in here, and that's why there's no headliner in here anymore, because we tried to fix the spots up on the bow up here that where we thought it was coming from, but we ended up just having to pull the headliner back and figuring it out from the inside. We put a tongue and groove hemlock in here with like a whitewash stain on it. The bunks are pretty much the same, just faced with beadboard and new trim. Not much really changed in here besides the ceiling. This room up here is the master stateroom. This room is probably the room that we changed the most. Originally, you walked into this room and there were four bunks in here. There were two on either sides. And these shelves are actually the fiberglass support for those bunks. And it was set up kind of like a fishing boat cruise quarters, and it just seemed odd. The original wall actually came out to here too, and there were closets on either side.
Oh, from here?
Yeah, so the door was actually right here. Oh, sorry, I just went in front of the camera, but the door was about to where the end of this door was here, and you had a closet on that side, which was actually the closet for the bunk room over there. So it was just a wall right here.
Uh-huh.
And then where I'm standing was the closet for this room. And we still kept a closet, but we just pushed it back this way.
Oh, okay.
And then we framed in a queen-size bed platform here. We have storage underneath here. There's a little... This goes down into the bilge, where forward bilge is right here, this hatch. And then we have storage all under the bed here, as well as... Well, these knobs aren't in yet. Drawers all the way around the bed.
His friends, they do home renovations, and they've been doing...
Is this your box? The headliner didn't match up with the new layout, so we had to put more tongue and groove ceiling in here.
And that same hemlock?
Yep, tongue and groove hemlock.
Yeah.
Is that, how do you think that'll hold up, like, in marine environment?
I think it'll do all right. We acclimated all the wood first before we installed it, so we kind of let it sit in here for a while. Same thing you have to do with the flooring. Like I said, I'd go with a different brand next time because this stuff has actual wood product in it. This is all Total Boat product right here. This is a Total Tread paint.
Is it one part or two part?
One part.
Okay.
Yeah. And then the primer and the top side coat are Easy Epoxy.
Okay, from Pettit?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But yeah, there was a long time where this boat just had green and white epoxy marks everywhere on it. So it was a lot of sanding and fairing and the teak cap rails we decided to just let gray for this winter because we're going into some bad weather here.
Just sanded it and then nothing just...
Yeah, and we used this great product called, Ken's would know. But it's a two-part system. It's a stripper, it's a teak brightener. So part one strips it and it turns like almost black with all the gunk that it pulls out of it.
Oh, wow.
And then you rinse that off and you put the brightener on it and it brings it back to look like original teak when it was first put on.
Okay.
And it's grayed since then, so it's pretty gray now. But the other thing with people being on here is a rental. If you have something like this in your pocket and you nick the varnish on it, it just water gets in and it bubbles and it's awful.
Yeah. We've used on some teak in the past just oil, like
And that's what we plan on doing, I think, is just oiling it.
Yeah.
This boat had massively tall antennas on it, and for people from Seattle that might know, we were taking it off of Lake Washington and we actually hit the Fremont Bridge.
Oh no. Yeah. Did it break anything or?
No, I mean the antennas were like a fiberglass antenna, and so they actually bent pretty well and they didn't break, but I thought we ripped that mast off when we were coming through. It was terrifying. Not much, if any, rot up here that we had to deal with besides that one wall. Most of it was in the back, but this roof right here where that drain is in the corner, you can kind of still see where my repair is, but I had to take out like a 1x2 section of it. And we had a skylight for a long time.
Mm. You guys just made this front hangout area?
Yeah, and eventually we want to put a gate right here so you don't have to climb over. And the one thing that's weird about this boat is it doesn't have a gate here, and then it doesn't have a boarding gate in the back.